Dhammakaya Media Center presents The Life of a Dhammadayada. Person who intends to train himself gives up his own immediate pleasure in order to work for the benefit of the teaching of the Buddha, for people around him, and for his country. Such a person trains himself until he has both worldly, practical knowledge and Dhamma, or spiritual knowledge. He will have a nice manner of behaving which is attractive to all those around him. Are there people like this in our society? We are seeking and awaiting people with such characteristics, characteristics which make them Dhammadayadas, heirs of Dhamma. A Dhammadayada is a person who makes the light of wisdom shine both for himself and for those around. Wat Pradhammakaya gives training courses for students and graduates who aspire to become Dhammadayadas. Here we follow the progress on such a course of one student named Monkon by means of extracts from the letters he wrote home to his mother. Monkon's mother is thinking, "You are my only son, and I wish you to have trust in Dhamma. I have long wanted to see you in yellow robes, and am extremely glad that you have asked to be ordained. I have never regretted your leaving home and leaving the family without your help for this time, because I'm certain that the way you have chosen will lead to a bright and safe destination." Monkon writing to his mother from Wat Pradhammakaya. "Dear Mother, I realize that parents want their children to have a bright future and conduct their lives in a good way. You also want me to be like that, and I too wish that. Therefore, I asked for Dhamma training here. I am educated, but deep in my heart, I feel that I am not truly educated. I have heard of this course before and feel that following it will make me educated in a more genuine sense." The course director, Venerable Tanawuto, is speaking about the purpose of the courses. He says, "We realize that a person who gives himself to work for the benefit of his friends, relations, and country needs not only practical knowledge, it is also essential that he has Dhamma in his heart. Only then can he correctly contribute to the nation. The Buddha showed that knowledge in a bad person can bring disaster to himself and those around him. Examples of this be that a person with agricultural skills may use them to grow opium poppies, or a person with knowledge of chemistry may use that knowledge to extract heroin. This is the reason why we have the Dhammadayada training courses and the summer mass ordination program. The aim is to train educated people so that their worldly knowledge and skills are combined with morality and meditational experience."
Dhamma, 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 Dhamma.
Mongkon writes, Mother, we all had to have field exercise training for the first 3 days. There were many kinds of training in physical endurance. The training unit does not train Dhamma Dyadas exclusively. It provides training for various official and private organizations. Some of us wondered why field exercise training is necessary when we wish to ordain. The experienced Dhamma Dyada in charge told us to follow the training, and we would understand its usefulness later after our ordination. When we first arrived at the temple, we were all sunburned. This shows the general willingness to face and overcome any obstacles. At Wat Pra Dhammakaya, we were all amazed by the buildings and things surrounding us. The impressive shrine standing so peacefully. Its contemporary architecture is different to other temples, but despite its simplicity, it can fulfill every needed purpose. The surroundings are composed of quiet and peaceful woodland, covering a large area of 800 acres. On this occasion, they used the Dutanga area, which is quite far from the shrine, for training. This is in the newly acquired area with no trees or bushes at all. So the sun is so hot that the soil is cracked due to the heat. I don't mind where I stay, as I intend to be here in order to train myself, not for comfort. I received an umbrella, a mosquito net, a mat, and a plastic sheet. These are provided to us by the temple. I look rather strange and funny with the umbrella on my left shoulder, the mat in my arms, and carrying my shoulder bag as well. Next, I set up the umbrella. From now on, for 2 months, this umbrella would be a nice, simple little home. Mum, the umbrella does not contain much space. There's only space enough to sleep. People come into this life with nothing and continue to acquire possessions until they have a lot. But I am now returning to have nothing. I would really like to know which is better. After we'd finished setting up our umbrellas, we all had our hair shaved off. Some asked why we had to have our hair shaved today, since there was 1 more month left before ordaining. However, after shaving, I felt well and comfortable. No more worries, no need to care for my hair. A mirror would no longer mean anything to me. I liked sleeping under the umbrella. I have had an idea. If once a year every person in the world could spend a period of time living under an umbrella and undertaking Dutanga or purification practices, the world would certainly have more peace. Under the umbrellas, no one is more privileged than anyone else. People are all equal, no arguments. This would make them know the difference between the words need and want. I would like to ask the teacher for permission to use an umbrella at home. Staying here, I cannot wake up late. We must get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, gathering to chant and meditate together.
Arun Rung.
When the sun rises, we start to practice walking meditation. We all dress in white and keep the 8 precepts. We have to be disciplined, patient, and respectful of each other. If you came here, you would see thousands of Dhammadayada in orderly lines, whether they are sitting, walking, or whatever they are doing. Everybody must try to be conscious of their actions with body, mind, and speech. Each person tries to keep quiet and concentrate only upon practicing meditation and keeping the mind free from mental chatter. We all practiced 3 less and 1 more. 3 less means speak less, eat less, and sleep less. 1 more means meditate more. Usually we sat in meditation for hours at a time. Some complained they could hardly bear the acute pain of their legs. I felt bad for the first few days, but later I got used to it. When my mind became more unified, I felt an unusual contentment. It was a kind of happiness I have never in my life experienced before, but it is difficult to describe. I wish you could experience the same happiness. It is a happiness that money cannot bring. I realize that there is no happiness higher than a still mind. Dhamma teaching was given in the afternoons by senior monks. They have a way of teaching which makes Dhamma seem very simple and applicable to daily life. After each lecture, there were meetings in small groups to discuss and summarize the teaching received. The senior monks were very kind and treated us like close relations. This made me feel at home. One day, in the afternoon, a violent rainstorm came unexpectedly. The wind was so strong and so sudden that within a few minutes, the large area where 1,000 umbrellas had been set up was filled with water. All our belongings were soaking wet. I never expected to face such a situation in my life. However, this can be regarded as a good lesson to train ourselves in endurance. Some participants who couldn't continue, faced with the bad weather, the strict discipline, and the serious meditation practice, took down their umbrellas and went home. I felt that I was part of a natural process of selection. I was absolutely determined to stay on to the end. If I gave up already at the first step, how could I go on to the next? Today we had the opportunity of setting up our umbrellas around the shrine. The atmosphere was so suitable for Dhamma practice that my meditation was exceptionally good. The ordination date is so soon that I have to prepare myself as well as I can. I have to remember the morning and evening chanting and become thoroughly familiar with the details of the ceremony. All the participants have been asked to train themselves both in mind and body to become genuine monks. Otherwise, when their parents offer respect to them after the ceremony, they would feel uncomfortable. The monks continually exhort us to examine ourselves to see whether we are ready. If after our ordination we do not behave properly, we would be cheating our parents, our sponsors, and those who give alms out of faith. If we behave badly, we will get demerit instead of merit from being monks. We go to sleep very late, after 10 o'clock every night. But we feel happy in our hearts because the mind is calmed by meditation all the time. The ordination day was the most important day, the day that everyone had been waiting for. I would have the chance to see both your mother and my sisters after a month away. At the mass ordination, ceremony at the marble temple, you will have seen the Dhammadayadas in white and newly shaved, all lined up in order of age. All were ready for ordination. Everyone was calm and quiet, keeping their eyes on the ground while repeating quietly the word Sama Arahang. When the bell rang, we walked in procession 3 times around the marble temple in a clockwise direction as a gesture of respect, led by the guests of honor, the Deputy Prime Minister and 4 other government ministers. They were invited to present robes donated by Her Royal Highness Princess Sirintorn to selected representatives of the Dhammadayadas. Then it was time to receive our robes. Never before in my life have I felt so happy. I believe everybody felt the same way. I felt very grateful to my parents and my teachers, including the sponsors of the ordination, after asking forgiveness for anything wrong I might have done in the past. Many people shed tears of joy. So did you, Mother. I made a firm resolve to do my best as a monk to practice Dhamma for the sake of Nibbana, in order to pay my debt to my mother and give merit to my father wherever he may have been reborn. A resolve to lead the way to Nibbana for both myself and my parents, no matter how many lives it might take. Yours respectfully, Mongkon. Here we see some of the parents of the Dhammadayadas expressing their strong feelings of love and gratitude. They believe that their sons have greatly benefited from the course and wish to convey their gratitude to the organizers. Now a mother and sister of one of the new monks are being interviewed. The sister is being asked about her brother's behavior before joining the course and replies that it was sometimes good and sometimes bad. Writes, after the ordination, the Dhammadayada monks return to Wat Pra Dhammakaya to continue practicing. The routine was similar to before the ordination, except that there were now more than 200 precepts in place of 8, and more subjects to be studied. The first day of going for alms, I dressed as neatly as I could. I felt awkward when people bowed to me. I did not believe in the idea that people pay respect to the yellow robe. There's nothing special about the yellow robe. They probably paid respect to the good deeds and precepts which I had been trying to practice. This made me uncomfortable, as it made me think whether I was worthy of such respect or not. Going for alms was one kind of walking meditation. While gathering alms food, we also meditated. This helped us to be self-controlled so that walking without shoes did not hurt our feet. While collecting alms, we're not supposed to look at the donor, but sometimes I couldn't help looking, as I was expecting to see you. After gathering alms, we would eat together. While eating, we had to be self-controlled and reflect that food we were eating, given out of the faith of the donors, was simply to maintain the body and give strength in order to practice Dhamma. The important thing about eating in a black bowl is that we have to concentrate all the time. Otherwise, the fork and spoon will strike the bowl and make a loud noise. Everyone will look at us. The life of a monk is very simple. The clothes are just three pieces of cloth. We wear the same robes for all occasions. People joked that casual wear and evening dress were just the same. In fact, it is very convenient. There is no need to worry about clothes. It was the supreme wisdom of the Lord Buddha that he could make full use of such simple garments. Certainly, it must be the result of special good deeds in the past that I now have the opportunity of wearing these robes. Visakha Puja was the most important festival held at the temple while I was a monk. All of us had to rehearse special chants and ceremonies in order to give blessings to the people who came to the temple. There were thousands of monks from all parts of Thailand, even some from Japan, and thousands of lay people all gathered for the ceremony. People were dressed in white and seemed bright and happy. The large expanse of the temple grounds looked small with so many thousands of people there. The most impressive experience of all that I will never forget was the 130-kilometer Dutanga walk. The length of the line of monks was more than 1 kilometer. This must be the longest line of people I have ever seen. We started early in the morning and walked approximately 16 kilometers a day. It took us 7 days to reach the destination. None of us had ever taken a long walk like this before, but we did not give up.
ทุกองค์รวนไม่เคยเดินทางไกลอย่างนี้มาก่อนเลยแต่ก็ไม่มีใครย่อท้อหรือยอมแพ้เมื่อพระอาจารย์ผู้นำยังคงก้าวรุดหน้าไปเรื่อยๆพวกเราจึงสวมใจสิงสู้เดินจนบรรลุเป้าหมายปลายทางทุกวัน
People brought us food and drinks made from small fruit when we stopped at rest areas in temples or schools. The faith of the donors delighted and encouraged us, even though we were so tired. I now realized why there was field exercise training at the beginning of the course. Step by step, I walked across Thailand. Along the way, we passed through rice fields, orchards, hills, and other types of countryside. This made us appreciate what we possess in our country. We all love the freedom and simplicity of Dutanga walking. Not many people have had such a precious and impressive experience. The Dhammadayada Dutanga group settled down at Khao Yai National Park for 5 days. For the whole time, I felt that every minute there was something precious. The senior monks gave special teaching sessions every day. The experience we all had here is very hard to describe.